Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel Learn Web Coding. My name is Durgesh Sahani and I'm here with a new video tutorials on .stxs file. So what is .stxs file? It's an Apache directory level configuration file. By using this, you can override or create a new rule for your Apache web server. You can use it for authorizations, error handling, redirections, cache controls, user permissions, and for several other things. So if you want to know more about .stxs file, here is the official site. From here you can understand in depth. So it provide a way to make configuration changes on a per directory basis. Okay, so here are some examples which we are going to see. Redirection from one website to another, authentications using .st password file will cache an image for a specific time, remove .php extension from URL, handle custom URL. Okay, so let's start now. See, I have installed this XAMPP and my Apache is running, and if you see, the default location of installation of this XAMPP is C drive. Under XAMPP folder you will find stdocs. Here we have to host our site, right? So if you go to the browser and if you type this localhost, it is redirecting to dashboard, because over here in index.php, see, here is the logic for redirection. So I'm just going to remove this so that it will not redirect. See, so on localhost my index.php file is running. Now what I want is, whenever any user come to this localhost, it should get redirected to tutorials.lcl, which is my new domain. Okay, so how will do that? Here I'm going to create a new file and save this into stdocs with .stxs. Okay, and the first thing you have to do is you have to start the rewrite engine on. Now the next thing is, we have to say redirect. 301 means permanent redirect. Now next thing is, this whole site, if any request coming to this, then it should go to http://tutorials.lcl. okay, now let's refresh this page and see what happening. You can see, as soon as you are writing this localhost, it is taking you to tutorials.lcl. So this is how you can redirect from one site to another. Now the next thing is, here is the tutorials, and this is the index file we are running. Now I'm going to create a new index file, or just say save as d tutorials over here. So here also have, as this is the directory level configuration file, so we can keep it at every directory. So here I don't want to do this redirection, but I want to make the authentication. So if anyone coming over here, they should be valid user. So for that, you should have some, see, I'll just copy the code over here. See, authentication type is basic, authentication name is restricted content, file name, here we have to specify the path and the file name. So I'm just going to create this file first, save this file with .stpasswd. okay, now here you have to specify the path. So you can see it is on D drive, so I'll go here and show you tutorials, then this is the file, right? So this will be the path. Here you have to specify complete path or absolute path, you can say. Now require is valid user should be valid. So here I'm going to create one user which is Durgesh, and password is 12345. Now see, if you refresh this page, you will see this authentication pop-up. Here you have to specify username and password. If you're not specifying, you will not be able to access this URL. Now, if I'm making some mistakes, then also it will ask you again. So now 12345, correct URL, correct password, user and password. So you can see now I'm able to access this. Okay, so this is how you can authenticate for us. If there is some credentials you have saved in a particular folder and you don't want to give access to everyone, in that case you can use this authentication, ST access authentication. Okay, now the next thing is we are going to see, which is cache. We'll cache one image for specific time. So I'm just going to get some image. Okay, from here. So this image is about 17.4 MB. So I'm just going to copy this to our directory. Okay, and index.php file over here. Let's include it. Dot png. I'm just going to open the console panel. So here you can see I'm just refreshing this page, and just see, it takes some time to load this file. Okay, because this is a big file, and if you see it's, let me just, okay, if you see here, status is okay and it is loaded from the file. Every time you refresh, it will try to load the file, right? And it will take some time because it's a huge file. Now if you want to cache it, so in that case in staccess file you have to write some logic, some rule, and that I'm going to paste it over here. See, file match if .jpg, jpeg, png, gif or swf file are there. So header set cache control max age is this much, so it will be for 1 week. Okay, so you have to specify here. Let me open the calculator so I'll show you. See, here you have to specify minute. Okay, so if I'm writing here like 60, so this will be for, if you provide 60, it will be for 1 minute. Okay, if you say 60 into 60, so for 1 hour. Again, for 24, so it will be for 1 day. Into 7, so it will be for 1 week. So this whatever image we have caching, it will be available for 1 week. So let me show you, you will see the difference. Preserve log. So see, here you can see required method get and status you are seeing here. If you refresh this, you can see from memory cache. And let me just delete all the things. See, wait a minute. Now it's showing less than 1 MB, right? If you refresh this page, okay, we have to again provide the credential. Now see, this is the image, and here you are saying status is okay. Now if you refresh it again, and if you try to see here, it will show you from memory cache. Okay, now it is loading from memory, and here you can see max age is what we have provided. Okay, so it will be available for, if I'll just open it again, so you can see 17 MB. As you can see, my image was for 17.MB, so it is showing over here. And once you refresh it again, you can see here it is loading from cache, right? So this is how you can create caches, and so it will improve your website performance. Now the next thing is, we are going to see which is remove PHP extension from URL. So here if you write index.php, still it will load. But if you remove this .php, it will not work for you, right? It will show some error that this is not exist. So that you can do by writing some condition. And so here I'm just going to paste some code. See, rewrite condition. If request file name, whatever the file we are trying to we are writing after this URL, okay, so index, right? We are writing index. So if it is exist and we are saying file and this is not, so if the file is not exist, then what we are going to do is we are writing that this dot. If this dot is not there, then whatever the data we have in URL we have written, that .php, try to open with that name. Okay, so if you see, refresh this page again, you will see it is loading index, it is loading. If you're writing here post, it will not work because post is not there. And if you go here and create a new file with post.php and HTML, here I'm just going to write post. Okay, refresh, you can see it is working for you, right? So this is how you can remove a dot extension from URL. For that you have to write this logic, rewrite condition and rewrite rule. Okay, now next thing is what I want to write. If I say hello, it should work for me, and I don't have any page. So you can write like this. See, again rewrite rule. If it start from hello, then load index.php file. Now if you refresh it, you will see index.php file only. Okay, again you can say index, it will work, or hello, it will work, right? So this is how you can achieve this handle custom URL. So I hope you understand what is this .stxs file is and how you can use it for different uses. If you have any doubt, let me know in the comment box. I'll try to provide you answer. And please like my videos. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.